Because of the ink that you're using and the material that you're printing on, a printer can only print a certain range of colors, and this range is called color gamut. Officially speaking, color gamut is the entire range of colors and tones that is achievable by an imaging system. So the color gamut that can be produced by your computer screen might be different, and actually is different, from the color gamut of your printer. And it can differ from printer to printer. Now let's say you're working with an image which has this much range of colors. Now your printer can only print this much range of colors. Everything which is beyond this range won't be printed properly. Today I'm going to share with you a very important Photoshop shortcut that is going to warn you every time there's a color which is beyond the range of what your printer can print. So without any further ado, let's get started. Back in the brilliant world of Photoshop, and if you want to go ahead and download this photo and follow along, check the links in the description. Now, if you have a closer look, we are working with an sRGB document. If you cannot see it, click on this arrow right there at the bottom, and then make sure you choose Document Profile. It's going to show you the color profile of the document. Now we need to determine what is going to be the color gamut of your printer. So for that, we need to go to View, and then Proof Setup, and you need to choose the color gamut of your printer. By default, it is of course working CMYK. It might be different for you. So you can choose Custom, and in the Device to Stimulate section, you can choose the color gamut of your printer. I'm just going to keep it as working CMYK and hit OK. Now you can do all of these settings that totally depends upon what printer you have. So by default, I'm just going to leave it to CMYK. So it is View and Proof Setup and working CMYK. Now I don't know if you have noticed this, but have a look at the document title. It is still RGB. It is 8 bits. However, it shows CMYK here as well. This just means that this is a CMYK preview, which can be toggled with the shortcut Control or Command Y. It's a great way to look at your image before printing. So Control or Command Y, it's going to show you the print preview. Control or Command Y again, this is the original image. So it's going to show you whatever you have set up. I have set up CMYK. If I go to View, Proof Setup, I have set up CMYK. You can set up any of these settings or choose Custom. You can choose the exact settings for your printer, and it's going to show you the preview of how it's going to be printed. So Control or Command Y, it's showing you the CMYK preview. Control or Command Y again, this is the original document. But I promised you a shortcut for the warnings, right? Here's how to do it. If you just press Control Shift Y, Command Shift Y on a Mac, have a look. All of those areas where you have color which is beyond the range of CMYK or whatever you have selected, it's going to show up in gray. So the colors in all of these areas won't be printed properly. Now you, my friend, can go ahead and automatically convert this to CMYK by going to Edit and then Convert to Profile and then choose CMYK and all of that. But working in CMYK isn't easy. And also, as you're working with the image and you're working for print, you need to make sure that you're working with the right colors. So you can fix it right here with the help of HueSaturation. So click on the adjustment layer icon and choose HueSaturation. That way, you also do not affect the colors in the other areas which are well within the range. So all we have to do is to look at the color which is crossing the range. In this case, it is reds. So from the drop-down menu right here, let's choose reds and simply decrease the saturation. You see that gray going away? However, if we zoom out and let's have a look at the before and after, this is before, this is after. The entire image is affected. We don't want that. We only want the reds in the dark areas to go away. So what do? Blend if. Double click on the right hand side of the layer. The layer styles dialog box shows up. So now in this case, you can of course do it with the underlying layer and control it. However, for more precise control, since this is reds, you can just choose reds from the blend if dropdown. So right here, let's choose reds and we want to take it away from the bright areas. So see, the red is being restored. And if we go anything beyond that, that warning is coming up. So let's split it. hold the Alt key or the Option key, click on the slider to break it apart, and split it. There you go. That looks better. Now, hit OK. If you want even more precise results, because if you have a look now, here's the before, here's the after, a little bit, only a little bit of the other areas are being affected. However, you can click on the mask, press Ctrl or Command I to invert the mask, and only paint with white on the areas which are affected, right here. Make sure the flow is 100%, opacity 100, and there you go. Now this is print perfect, no warnings at all. To turn off the warning, press Ctrl Shift Y again. Now the warning is turned off. Now you might ask, how to check whether the warning is turned off or turned on? Simple, just go to View and see if there's a check near Gamut Warning. So if you click on Gamut Warning, it is turned on. If we turn off the Hue Saturation layer, you will see the warning. If you go to View again and click on Gamut Warning again, it turns off. Now some of you might ask, why not convert this to CMYK from the very beginning and then start retouching? Well, there are two reasons why we don't do that. First of all, the color gamut of every printer is very different. So if we set up the color gamut from very beginning, we would be limited to just printing from that printer. Also, there will be limited availability of colors. Secondly, working in CMYK is a challenge. Let me show that to you. So let's say we convert this to CMYK by going to Edit and then Convert to Profile. And from sRGB, we choose the destination space or convert to profile working CMYK and hit OK. All right, now this is CMYK. However, in this case, if we just go ahead and click on the adjustment layer icon and then choose curves, have a look at this. There is CMYK, and now we need to work with cyan, magenta, yellow, and black instead of simple red, green, and blue. We have learned so much to do with RGB channels that it's hard to work with this. Also, if you click on the adjustment layer icon again, exposure is not available, vibrance is not available. There's a lot of things which are not available here. If you go to filter, have a look. 3D is not available, blur gallery is not available. You get the point. That's why we work with RGB, and in the end, you can do whatever you want with your image. According to your printer, you can make a copy and convert that to CMYK or whatever color gamut that suits your printer. And then you can also adjust the colors even in RGB and then print. The options are endless. However, if you do it in the beginning, you will be limited. I hope that answers your question, and I hope this video helps you. And if it does, make sure to give us a like, and also don't forget to subscribe, and not just subscribe, ring the bell so that you, my friend, don't miss any other future tips, tricks, or tutorials. However, if you want a complete video on how to get the perfect prints, I mean, if you want to get absolutely close to what you're getting on print to what you see on your screen, I would highly recommend to watch this complete guide by professional Photoshop expert, photographer, printer, Glenn Dewis. It's a complete 50 to 55 minutes guide which will take you through the entire process of soft proofing, color calibration, printing, and all of that fun stuff. So if you're into that, go ahead and watch this video. Thank you so much for watching this video. I hope to see you again in my next one. Till then, stay tuned and make sure that you keep creating.